what you have accomplished to determine your social status.
在美国呢，更重要的就是你究竟成就了什么，才能让人觉得好像你的社会地位有多高。
So someone with more education is considered to be of a higher social status.
如果有人受到了比较多一点的教育，他可能就社会地位比较高一点。
It may be hard for you to understand why an older person is not being treated with respect, but it may be because they're very poor or they have no social status.
在这边可能有的时候你就没办法理解为什么长辈们没有被特别的尊重，很有可能是因为他们自己的教育，他没有受很多教育，所以大家就他可能很穷，所以大家不尊重，有人就不尊重他了。
I think that's not right. I think we should respect everyone, but you will notice that in American culture.
我个人认为这个是错误的。我觉得我们应该尊重所有的人，但是你可能会注意到美国的文化中间是有这样的特点。
Okay, the rule of law.The way laws are determined in the U.S. may be different than the way laws are determined in other countries.
这是法律作为规范，在美国法律来规范事情的办法，可能跟在其他国家也不是完全一样。
One of the biggest differences that you will notice between China and the U.S. is that the U.S. has laws at the federal level, at the state level, and at local levels.
你在中国跟美国有一个不一样的地方，你会发现在美国哈，它有联邦的这个法，然后州政府的法，然后地方政府的法。
And that may seem different politically. That works out very differently.
所以这个政治上好像是特别不同，所以它也是结果有跟不一样。
So they may feel a bit different to you, but each country has their way of doing things.
你可能是你会觉得很不同，但是每个国家都会有不一样的办法。
For this summer, remember what the campus rules are, because there are rules that are only for this campus that might be different. That's your most, what you need to know this summer, is to remember the campus rules.
所以今年夏天呢，就主要记着这个校园里边的这个法规，因为这个可能是你最需要记着的。
And I think things, when you go out into public spaces, what are you allowed to do or not to do in public spaces? Maybe they talked about that already too.
然后你要是到外边，你可能也会有些规定，有些事情可以做，有些事情不能做。不过我们刚才也谈到一点点。
And then I want to talk about regional differences. You will notice this is very rough map of the United States. We're on the East Coast in Pennsylvania.
下面我想谈不同地区有什么不同。你可以，这个是一个很简单的美国地图。我们是在东海岸。
So this would be Florida. This would be California.
下面那个小角，这个小
角
佛罗里达，然后旁边是那个右边是加州，是个很奇怪的一个地图。
You will notice that there's very different cultures on the East Coast than in the South, than on the West Coast, than in the middle part of the country that we call the Midwest.
你可能会注意到，在东海岸跟到南部，还有西海岸，还有中部这些地方，其实很多文化呢都很不同。
If you follow the U.S. news while you were here this summer, we are coming up on a presidential election, and you will begin to notice these differences.
如果你要是已经在追踪美国的新闻，因为我们十月份就会美国总统大选，你就会发现这些不同地区反应完全是不一样的。
Because the presidential candidate who wants to win votes will say something different on the West Coast and something different on the East Coast.
如果想竞选总统的这个总统竞选人，他们到西海岸讲的话，跟在东海岸讲的话就完全不一样。
So pay attention, you will learn something when you see that.
你可以注意他们的表现。
Generally, for where we live here on the East Coast, life is fast. We move very fast.
一般来讲，在我们东海岸住的人，生活节奏是比较快的。
There's a lot of population, what they call Boston, New England, the whole way to Washington, D.C. is what, one big city. So everybody's traffic, busy, everybody's running to their work.
所以有这个整个一片从新英格兰那边然后到首都整个一大片其实就像一个大的城市一样每个人都是在慌慌张张的这样的来回的跑去工作各种各样的事情。
If you go further west, there will be more farms, and life might be just a bit slower.
如果你往西部再稍微走一点点，就有很多的农庄，生活速度就慢一些，节奏就慢一些。
And last, relationships. I think this is the hardest thing for international students is to understand how Americans relate.
最后一个就是关系，我想这个是对于我们这些外国学生来讲最不好理解的，美国人美国人之间这个关系究竟是怎么回事。
And my friend Ping has been very successful because she married an American man.
我觉得我很成功，我就结婚有一个美国的先生。
I married a Mexican man, so I also know what it means to relate cross-cultural.
我是他是他的先生是墨西哥人，所以他很能理解这种不同文化的人这样结婚，这样的建立关系。
So you have to learn to relate to people who are different than you, and it takes some learning to do that.
所以你可能要学习去跟那些人跟你完全不一样的人怎么能够建立关系，所以这中间要逐渐来学习。
Americans might tend to be very casual. For example, they'll say, let's do lunch sometime, but they never get back to you and they never say when we're going to do lunch.
美国人可能是特别的随意，他会说，哦，咱们一块儿什么时候去吃午餐，可是他从来也不再从来以后就再也不跟你讲到底什么时候，或者是在什么时间，或者在哪里。
And they don't mean to be rude, they're just very casual.
他们不是很粗，他们不是很粗鲁，他们就是说是很随意的人。
But it would be fine, it would be good if you would go back to them and say, "Hey, I really do want to do lunch with you sometime."
如果你要是专门就是说你要专门跑回去再跟他讲，说哎呀，那我真的很想，我们什么时候一块儿出去吃午餐，这样是可以的。
And that is, they will accept that and like that.
他们就会接受，他们也会喜欢。
I guess that's enough.
Yeah, 这差不多了。
So, some advice that other international students have. This is coming from a book called U.S. Classroom Culture. So other international students have talked about what helped them be successful.
有些建议是从其他的一些国际学生，他们写了一本书《美国教室文化》，他们想帮助其他的国际学生。
So once you are here, find someone that you can ask questions to, someone to show the ropes is the expression.
当你来到美国之后，你就能够找到什么人，他能够帮助你来解决问题。他这个英文的说法叫 show you the rope, 就是来用这个大概意思。
It's an expression that means someone that you can ask questions to and they can explain things to you.
这个意思，那个字的意思，他是说你可以问这个问题，他可以帮助你回答。
So that was your English class for today. You know one expression.
所以你今天的英文课就是学了一个词，学了一个表达方式 ，show the ropes.
Something else that helps you be successful: be independent, learn to do things, and not be afraid to try new things.
像另外一个就是要能够学习独立，能大胆去试新的标靶。
Be prepared.
然后做好准备。
That's one reason we give you an orientation so that you can know some things.
这就是我们为什么今天会有这样的一个课，让大家可以知道你将要面对的是什么。
Try to adapt. Try to learn to do things the way the Americans do things. It's good to learn.
学习适应，也学习适应美国人他做事的方式，可以帮助你学习一些东西。
Sometimes it's easier to stay with people who are like you, find other Chinese students and stay together, but you learn more if you make American friends.
有的时候当然你跟自己的中国同学待在一起你会觉得舒服一些，但是呢你要是跟美国学生待在一起虽然难，但是你可以学到更多一些东西。
Everyone has similar experiences. You might think, why is it so hard? But probably the other international students are having the same troubles.
就是说每个人都有一些很类似的经历，虽然你可能会觉得哦，那我怎么这么难，其实其他的国际学生都有同样的经历。
Can I put a bookmark in the packet? Yeah, in your packet there's a bookmark.
就在你这个夹子里边都会有一个书签。
One of our professors made this list to help international students.
我们中间有位教授就做了一个这样的表来帮助国际学生。
So here are top 10 ideas. I'm going to start at the bottom, number 10.
最重要的十个主意。
Cultivate a sense of humor.
要想办法觉得很就有幽默感。
Sometimes you make mistakes in what you say and you need to be able to say oops and laugh at yourself.
当你有的时候可能会犯错误，你呢觉得哦， 你要能够笑自己。
When I was studying in the university, I spent one semester in Central America in the country of Honduras.
我花了一个学期是在洪都拉斯中美洲那个地方待了一个学期。
I lived with a Honduran family, and one time I was eating lunch, and a frog jumped in from outside.
就我就跟一个洪都拉斯家庭一块儿住在一起，就有一天呢，在吃中餐的时候，就有一个青蛙，咚咚咚就跳进来了。The
mother was very clean. She liked to keep her house very nice, so I knew that she didn't want to have a frog in the house.
这妈妈是非常干净，那我知道她喜欢她的家里很干净，她肯定很不喜欢青蛙跳到她家里。I
couldn't remember how to say the word frog in Spanish.
因为但是我不知道用西班牙语怎么去讲青蛙。
So I told her, "Man, there's a pimple in the house."
所以我就跟她说，家里有一个这个疮，这个包，还有毛。
I used the wrong word.
那她这个词用的不对，她用错了。
And she looked at
me.
What?
就起了包。然后那个人就说啊，怎么？No.
And I pointed to the frog, and then she laughed.
他就后来就跑去指着那个青蛙，我就明白了，主人这个女主人就明白了，原来他是想说青蛙。
The words were not too different.
这两个在西班牙语里边都非常的接近，所以那个女主人后来明白他在说什么。Cultivate
a sense of humility.
然后再有要有一个谦卑的感觉，要有一个谦卑的心。It's
okay to learn. It's okay to do new things. It's okay to be wrong sometimes.
对，可以去学，可以去学新东西，可以去犯，甚至可以去犯一些错误。
Number 8, will you respond or will you react? If you respond, oh, okay. If you react, you become defensive. No, 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 no.
你这第八个问题呢，就是说，你究竟是要回应呢，你还是要反应？ 当你回应的时候，你会主动跑去解决问题；当你反应的时候，你就哦不行不行，你会有这样的一种感受。So
learn to try to respond graciously.
想办法就是说很有就是很优雅的跑去回应。Often
the person did not mean what you think.
因为那个可能是冒犯你一个人，他根本没有那个意思，
It was just a misunderstanding.
可能就只是大家有误解而已。Share
your host culture. God has you here for a reason. When you share with American friends things about your culture, then they learn too.
可以来跟大家来分享你自己的文化。上帝对于你们来这个地方有特别的计划。当你呢就把你们自己的文化来跟美国人这样子来分享，可以帮助他们。
I think that's a good reason for us to be together.
这就是我们可以是在一块的很好的原因。
You will also learn about your culture of origin. You will learn things about China that maybe you didn't think about before.
你也可以通过这样的方式可以学习你自己的文化，通过在美国这样的一个情况，你开始学习到你对中国的文化以前都不太注意、不太了解的地方。Get
plenty of rest. Even though you're learning English and you're sitting at a desk, you are working hard in your brain.
要多多休息，虽然你特别在你像学英语，你脑子实际上是很累的，是很辛苦。When
I lived in Mexico City, my husband would say, at 7 o'clock at night, we will speak English instead of Spanish because you need to rest.
我先生就说，晚上七点钟以后，我们就开始讲英语，因为你的脑子需要休息。
So he would speak English with me, which was his second language, in the evening to allow me to rest.
所以到晚上，他就用他的第二语言英语来跟我交流，这样让我可以休息一下。It
makes you tired sometimes.
有的时候是会让你觉得很累。Number
4, listen and collect stories.
第四呢，就是注意聆听，然后收集故事。
If you can remember stories when you go back home, you will tell the stories of things that happened, or write them down if you'd like to write.
当你回去之后，如果你能记着你今天白天发生的事情，可以把它记下来。特别如果你甚至可以把它写下来。
Sometimes you remember things better when they're stories.
当他当有的时候，当他你把它变成故事的时候，你就会对这些事情记得准确一些。
Number three, keep a daily journal, which is writing down things so that you can take it back with you when you go.
然后第三呢，就是学习写日记，这样你把每天在发生的事情写下来，然后当你回去的时候，就可以把这些带回家。
Number two, find a cultural informant or helper. That's kind of the same as this, finding someone that you can trust to ask questions to.
第二呢，你就是要找一个可以在文化上，在当地的文化上可以帮助你的人。
Maybe an American friend that you feel that you can ask questions.
可能是一个美国朋友，那这个朋友你知道你可以向他来问问题。
I don't understand why do Americans do this.
你可以问他哦，你可以问他啊，那我真的不知道美国人为什么要这样做，那他就会回答你。
And number one, make your journey in a different culture a spiritual adventure.
而且第一呢，就把你在另外一个文化中间的这样的一个生活，把它当成一个属灵上的一种生活。
You are growing and learning on many, many different levels inside, in your brain, in your heart. You are learning. It's a big adventure.
其实你是在各个方面都是在成长，都是在学习。无论是你的头脑，还有你的心灵，都是在成长，都在学习，是一个很美好的经历。
So I hope you will grow in your intellect, but that you will also grow in your emotions and in your spiritual way too.
我盼望着你不仅是在你的智慧，你在你的知识上可以这样子能够成长，也同时是在你的情绪上能够好好成长，而且在你在属灵上也能够成长。
You may not realize how much you are changing.
你可能不太知道你自己究竟有多少的变化。
But your psychology is.Understanding that you are changing.
那你的心理实际上是在变化，你心理上知道你在变化。
So, there's something we call culture shock, which is that transition that your mind goes through when you adjust to a different way of doing things.
当你在适应不同的事情的时候，你的大脑会经过这一系列的变化，我们把这个称为文化冲击。
Some people experience culture shock very strongly, and others hardly at all.
有人最经过文化冲击非常的强烈，但有人可能就没有什么感觉。
But if you do feel this, don't worry, it's normal.
如果你真的有文化冲击，你不用担心，这是正常的。
At first, when you're in a new place, it's exciting. There's all kinds of new things. It's almost like a honeymoon right after getting married.
如果你刚到一个地方，一开始就特别的让你兴奋，就好像刚刚结婚那个蜜月期间。
But then you might sink down in your emotions because you feel like I don't understand. Things are so different. I miss my food and my family.
然后你就突然就意识到中间你情绪上就有特别多的问题，你就会这样想着，那我不能理解到底发生什么事情。我实在是我也听不懂别人在说什么。我实在是非常想我自己喜欢吃的那个饭。我想我自己家里的人。
It's very normal to feel that way, but gradually you will get back.You will feel like yourself again soon.
这样的感受是非常正常，但是很快，逐渐的你就会重新回来，你就会觉得，你就会找到自己。
When you return to China, this may happen again because you did change while you were here. You grew. You're a different person than when you left.
当你回到中国的时候，你可能又有新的这样的问题，因为实际上你在这边这几个礼拜，你实际上是成长的，中间会有不同。
If you're here a number of years as a student and you go home, you notice the change in your own culture compared to what you had adapted to, and you may experience the same feelings again.
如果你要在这边几年待了几年之后，你要回到家里，你会发现这中间，你会发现你自己的文化跟你在其他国家这个文化真的是很不一样，你可能又要经历同样的这样的冲击。
But again, over time, you will readjust, so don't worry about it.
但是没关系，在一段时间之后，你又会重新的可以适应。
So best wishes for a safe and for a safe and happy visit.
我盼望着你们，我是祝你们在东方大学能有一个安全的、幸福的这样的一个时间。
And I have a gift for each of you from the Office of International Student Services.
我们有外国学生。外国学生办公室给你们
这
么一个礼物
you can carry your books.
这是给你们一个小包你们可以带你们的书
or a pair of sneakers if you go running.
或者你可以把你的鞋放进去
you can use it for anything you want.
可以做任何的事情用这个小包
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So welcome.
When you did orientation, I made you answer questions to get it back, didn't I?
Yeah.
Play the game.
当他们做这种
他们必须回答一个问题才能得到这个报酬。